Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is the radio guy, Dr. Mike Prince. We have with us head basketball coach for Prairie View men's basketball, Coach Byron Smith. The Panthers get off to a 2-0 start along with the ladies. This is the first time in 11 years that they had successful running of the Panthers, if you would. Let's welcome Coach Smith to the show. How you doing today, Coach?
I'm doing well. And yourself, Mike?
I'm doing wonderful, sir. Thank you for making yourself available and getting out to a quick start. You always want to at least go for the split on the road and protect your home court advantage. You're a little bit ahead of the game. Give us a recap of what you're seeing develop with your young Panthers.
I think, you know, finally, you know, things are just kind of, you know, coming together. Some guys that didn't really, you know, contribute probably as much as they would have liked in the non-conference. You know, I think they're kind of starting to come around. And I just think these two games, we just played two totally different type of games, Southern and Alcorn. But I just think we came together as a unit, and everyone that stepped out on the floor contributed in the ways that we felt that they could. I just think it's a unity. It's the closest right now. These guys kind of have each other's back, and they really enjoy playing with each other and competing. And I just think it's just been a total team effort in the both games that we won on Saturday and Monday. And it is good to see. Very refreshing as a head coach to see your unit playing as one.
Well, I've been on record for saying that a Coach Byron Smith team is a bunch of guys who are going to understand their roles on the team, get in where they fit in, and not necessarily a big superstar, even though if you would count the consistency of Blackston. But you get a bunch of guys that kind of buy in not only to each other, but to your concept and the philosophy and the direction that you try to hit this team. Is that the case for this 2018-19 group?
I think that's fair. I think it's a fair assessment, Mike, and you're right. And, you know, I think we kind of go one step further than the buy-in. It's called the believe-in. And believing in individuals, you know, more so than just a system. Because I think they buy-in, it's usually a system. And believe-in, you believe in people. And I think that's a lot more impactful. And we just have a great group of guys that come to work hard each and every day, and they believe in us as coaches, and it means a lot. It makes us feel really good about what we're doing, and it makes us that much more energetic and to want to try to connect with them as much and get to know them better and become closer to them. And so right now I think what you see is it's just a great chemistry that we're having from player to coach and coach to player, and we hope that will continue. And if it does, I think there's some great things in store for the 2018-19 Panthers.
Well, you're always looking for those pieces that you can add in that can help further you along down the road. And speaking of an interesting piece that you've had of late, Tristan Wallace, football player, now playing basketball. First of all, how did you come across that, and how has that been working out for you so far?
Well, I mean, you know, we play a lot of basketball here as coaches here on campus in the off season, and you know, we just happened to be, you know, shooting some hoops one day over in the rec, and this kid was like, you know, just jumping over top of people's head and getting rebounds, and he was a big physical kid and just kind of having fun. And, you know, he just kind of talked to, you know, Coach Musk, prize assistant, Landon Bussey. They just kind of had a bit of a conversation and, you know, said he'd like to give it a shot. You know, he played at DeSoto High School and they won a state championship. He and the kid over at Duke right now, Marquise Bolden. So he's played the game in high school and had some success, and they just kind of wanted to just come out and even give it a shot. You know, those football players, sometimes they think that they're invincible, they can do anything, got a lot of confidence. So he talked to us about it, and we talked to his parents about it. And obviously, we talked to Coach Dooley, and Coach Dooley was on board with it. You know, we talked to him, you know, early part of the summer about it, and he said he really encouraged his players to be dual sport guys. He felt like it helped them. And, so we thought it was a good idea to give it a shot. And obviously he's come out. He was a little bit banged up when he first came out a few weeks ago with hamstrings. So he kind of started off kind of on IR, but now he's just kind of starting to learn our system a little bit. And I think as we continue to move forward and we continue to get better and stronger, I think there's going to be some opportunities for him to get out and impact out on the court. How much that'll be, I don't know, because we've just got so many guys that want to play. We don't really have all the minutes to be able to give everybody what they feel that they need. But I think he's going to be able to serve a physical, tough role for us and be able to get in there, get some rebounds, and get some of those boosts, 50-50 balls. So, you know, we have a package for him. We just got to get him a little bit more familiar with what we're doing and being able to fit in a little bit better. And we think over time he will.
Okay, so you're telling me it was not a hard sell at all from the Ghost. He said, hey, if the guy's willing and you think you can use him, by all means, yeah, let him go.
Absolutely, and that's a beautiful thing. Everybody here TV athletics working together and trying to make this a special place. I like that. So, yeah, that's pretty much how it all came. I played out.
Mm-hmm. Well, that is awesome. The Panthers are 2-0 right now. There's no need to even try to attempt to hype up the opponent coming in this weekend. It's going to be the Texas Southern Tigers led by Johnny Jones. No secret what the Tigers have done. The special note that I had taken was that the Tigers were able to get a 10-point margin of victory over Southern without the presence of their postman, Reed. I know he's going to be there if he had to show up on crutches even for this weekend. What's the plan of attack to counter what Reed brings to the table?
Well, I mean, obviously, though, you know, when you're 7 feet or bigger, you know, you can have an impact anytime you want. There's no one on the court at any level of college basketball that can keep you from having some type of an impact. I mean, if it's scoring, if it's rebounding, if it's shot blocking, if it's just effort and energy, you know, you can account for something. And we know that. And obviously, the plan would be to go right at him. You know, if you shy away and you try to avoid getting your shot blocked, you're going to get your shot blocked. You know, the one that's aggressive, you attack shot blockers, you go right at the chest. You got to be smart. And the thing we tried to do last year was try to get them in foul trouble. You know, and I think sometimes teams let these guys off the hook because they're looking to shoot floaters and fadeaways and things like that. Well, let's go in and let's come to a 2-foot jump stop and get an up fake, maybe get him in the air, get him in foul trouble. And then and maybe he won't have as great of an impact as he probably could if he were playing 36, 37 minutes. But, you know, they've got so much more talent there, Mike, across the board that, you know, we can't just really focus in on one guy, but obviously he's the bigger guy. You know, he's the elephant in the room. So we'll make the adjustment and we'll try to play a quicker style and try to get out and run in transition. And hopefully he's not very energetic that day. He won't run back and protect the rim like we know that he can, but they are a complete basketball team top to bottom. They got guys that can shoot, dribble, and pass and got a lot of experience too. So they'll be a tough out. But I like what we're doing right now. I like the direction we're going in. I like how we're playing as a unit right now, playing together. And obviously it doesn't hurt to be playing at home. Hopefully have a nice home crowd. Students will be back on campus by then. So, you know, whiteout night at Texas Southern. So, hey, we're excited. We're looking forward to it. And I think we're going to come out and play some really good basketball on Saturday night.
Well, some good basketball has been the ingredient for, and I keep saying this and scratching my head, a defensive focus Byron Smith team. I'm still getting used to saying that, Coach.
I'm getting used to hearing it.
Now, Williams had a strong performance. Jones had a strong performance, but Blackston has been the model of consistency. What is it that makes Blackston the special ball player that he is day in and day out?
I think, you know, we challenge him each and every day. You know, we think, Mike, and I've said it for a while now, I think he has a legitimate chance to play at the next level. Now, what level that is, that remains to be seen. The NBA is hard at every level, but I think he's just got the type of game, he's got the type of scoring mentality, he's got the type of just style that, you know, those guys have a chance to go on and play at a very high level at the next level. So we challenge him every day, and we say that you get paid for consistency. You know, you're not going to get 25 one night, and the next night you get, next time you play, you get 4, and, you know, you take a bunch of shots, and you're just not playing team basketball, but you have to be consistent. So I've challenged him, and we challenge him to be consistent night in and night out. And that doesn't always mean he's got to make shots. He's got to take good shots. He's got to set his teammates up to get buckets off of him, to be a decoy sometime, to get his teammates scoring opportunities. And he's got to go in on the other end and be, you know, what they call the quintessential two-way player. You got to do it on the other end. And I'm really proud of him. The other night, he picked up 2 fouls, early fouls against Alcorn, and made it tough for him to make an offensive impact. But the time that he played, he really focused on defending the ball, keeping his man in front, not letting his man score the ball. And he led us in rebounding once again. He's our leading rebounder right now at 6'2". He goes up and he gets after. He's rebounding the ball as well as any guard in the country at any level right now. And I'm really proud of that. So he's really maturing as a basketball player. But make no mistake about it, Mike, we got to have the ball in his hand with him looking to score every time down. And if he can't score, then make the right play, make the right pass to someone else who's in a better scoring situation. But we go as he goes, and he's going to lead us. If anything good is going to happen here, he's going to have to be a part of it for sure.
We're talking right now with Coach Byron Smith of the Prairie View A&M University Panthers. 2-0 right now as they get set to take on Texas Southern this Saturday at the Baby Dome. Now, we know the importance of this Texas Southern game, and it would be, as they say, the land of La La to take this break going in with a 3-0. stands. Right now, not trying to look too far down the road, your next home set would be against Jackson State and Grambling. Surprisingly, Grambling off to a slow start, but that's still a team that you have to keep on the watch for throughout the course of this season. Is that safe to assume?
Absolutely correct, Mike. You know, they picked to win the league, I believe, or either second. I think they picked to win it. And they did last year, the regular season conference champion. So they're formidable, and they'll be tough again. And by the time they roll in here in a couple of weeks, they'll be clicking on all cylinders, because we're always going to get, for some reason or another, we're always going to get everybody's best shot. And I think a lot of times their season is marked, their conference season is marked by how they do against Prairie View and Texas Southern. So we'll get their best shot. And Jackson's a very good coach, you know. Jackson State has a very good coach, Wayne Brent. And, you know, obviously he'll have them ready to go when they come in here as well. But obviously the most important game is the next game, because it is the next game on our schedule. And that's where we're focused right now. And obviously the bells and whistles will be out, because it is the crosstown rival, or down the highway rival. And it is great. It's great for Prairie View Nation, as well as it is for the TSU Nation. They really get excited about it, a lot of pride and tradition. And we're aware of it. And I've made our new players that aren't, you know, that have not been here, I've made them aware of it, that it brings about a different sort of significance to the greater Houston area. And we'll be up for the challenge. I've played in many of these games, and they're always exciting and entertaining. And I have no reason to believe that it won't be that way again here on Saturday night. But I can assure you, Mike, come 5:45 or 6 o'clock when that ball goes up, you know, the Panthers will be ready to go.
Well, the stage is set. PV Nation on a roll. Coach Byron Smith back at home for some home cooking for this event against Texas Southern. Coach, I know you know, because coaches always do, but I'm just going to give you a little tidbit. You are now 5-1 against Southern in your coaching era. And that has got to be a pretty significant milestone with this early start to your career. And we're looking that you can become, if I'm not mistaken, you'll end up being 3-2 against Texas Southern with the win on this one. Is that correct?
Yes, I think so. I've got that stuff cut out and pasted on my wall at home. I think you guys call it bulletin board material to try to inspire and stuff like that. So, I love the game so much. It's such a blessing to be a part of it. And, you know, I approach every team the same. You know, I just want to give the Panthers an opportunity to be successful, to make, you know, my mark here, you know, because I'm eternally grateful to the powers that be that have given me this opportunity to be the head men's basketball coach here at Prairie View. It's an honor and a privilege to do it. And every day I'm going to go out and give my best effort, put my best foot forward, and just continue to try to get better and make everyone in PV Nation proud of the men's basketball team each and every year. And we've had more success against some teams than others. But, you know, I think every night we're going to always be competitive, and we're always going to play hard, and we're always going to play with Panther pride and passion, and want everyone to feel good about coming out to support us. We're definitely trying to make you alums proud, and hope that we have to this point. I think it's some greater days that lie down the line for PV men's basketball, and we're going to do everything we can to continue to get better and make you guys proud.
Well, once again, get your white on. It's a whiteout night for Prairie View Texas Southern. Starts at 3 p.m. with the women tip off, and follow 30 minutes at the conclusion of that game for the men to get it done on the hardwood. Coach, we want to thank you so much for making yourself available. As always, man, we get excited to having our weekly conversations with you here at the Open Mic Broadcast Network and the Mike Prince Show. And Lord say the same, we'll see you on Saturday, man. And let's go out there and get another one for PV Nation.
Sounds good, Mike. Thank you for having me.
All right. Coach Byron Smith, I'm the radio guy, Mike Prince. We'll pause for the calls, and we'll be right back. Hey, guys, this is Mike Prince with the Open Mic Broadcast Network. I have with me the owner of JCE Building and Restoration, Miss Patty Bear. How are you doing today, Patty?
I'm doing amazing. Thank you for the opportunity to be able to come here and talk with you and visit with you in reference to the type of work that I do.
Well, you know, the construction work, I tell you guys all the time,
that if you need some remodeling or even some new construction in your life, JZE Building and Restoration is the one. I'm here getting some work done, and let me tell you, she is worth her weight in gold. But just for those who are listening, Patty, tell them what all you guys do.
Well, we restore and renovate roof repairs, anything. I'm a one-stop shop, you know, able to help you from A to Z.
Absolutely. And when she says from A to Z, she means exactly from A to Z. You can give her a call at 832-319-8477. Set your appointment up today with JZE Building and Restoration.
This is Sandy Pugh, your head coach of Prairie View A&M University Panthers. Join us this Saturday for our annual whiteout game as we play host to Texas Southern at 3 p.m. at the Baby Dome. See you there.
How you doing, ladies and gentlemen? It is the radio guy, Dr. Mike Prince, and we have with us Coach Sandy Pugh. She goes to Baton Rouge, she goes to Lorman, Mississippi, and she comes back 2-0, getting ready to take on Texas Southern this week at the Baby Dome. Coach, how you doing today?
Hey, Mike. Doing fantastic.
You're doing fantastic. Boy, that sounds like that. I'm 2-0. Hey, Mike. Hey, Mike. I kind of like that.
That might have a little to do with it.
Yeah, I got you. You know, whistle while we work, right? It's all good. But look, Coach, strong performance, a dominating performance on Monday, to be more precise. But give us that recap as you went back to the scene of crown. I know you was trying to play it all like it's just another game, but I already know how the competitive juices flow. But you got through that. How important was that, not only for your team, but for you personally?
I just don't put any more, energy into one game as I do them all. I get prepared. The team is prepped. I expect them to go out and play hard and stick with the game plan. They did that, I thought we had a lapse there at the very end. We were up 7, should have gone up 9 and gave up a couple of 3 balls that they kind of threw up and went in down in Baton Rouge and kind of gave them a little hope. But, all in all, every time we hit the floor, I expect them to, just take care of the basketball, do the game plan, do the fundamentally sound stuff, and I think winning takes care of itself. So my mindset is totally different than the average person's, I guess, going into that type of situation. I'm looking at it from a very analytical perspective, and feelings don't have anything to do with it. So, it's a business. It's a business trip. And, my expectations were very cut and dried, and the kids knew what they were. If we met those, I knew we had a great chance of coming out of there with the W. And, we did a lot of some good things. Still have some places for growth. The game against Alcorn down in Lorman, I thought it was important that we jumped out on them early and maintained that energy. You can go down into Lorman, Mississippi, and win. Year in and year out, they've had some really good teams. This team probably isn't as good as some teams they've had in the past, but, you can't walk in there sleeping. They ran up on Texas Southern on Saturday. So, we weren't leaving anything to chance. So we went in there. The kids came out bouncing with great energy, jumped out on them early. I think Dobbins went like 10 for 11 from the field, 6 of 8 from the free throw. I think she missed her first 2 free throws and, went 7 for 7 from the field. So she had a phenomenal game. 8 rebounds, 27 points. Just did a great job for us.
Right now, we're speaking with Coach Sandy Pugh. Lady Panthers getting prepared for Texas Southern this coming weekend. Now, Coach, you just made reference to Shayla Dobbins, and it's no question that she is Miss Consistency. She's day in, day out. But let me tell you who my unsung hero and the actual player of the game for Monday against Alcorn. And it might catch you off, but I think you'll appreciate when I call this name. But Jaira Cobb, Only played 14 minutes, but my God, was it quality. She did everything that you need to have done on the back end, and she played a solid game, in my opinion.
You know, it's funny that you mentioned Jaira because I stay on her about having the sweet feet. You know, it's like she doesn't want to play a power game. She wants to do the, you know, the point guard stuff. And she had two plays that came up on the tape. And as soon as it happened, she looks at me and I look at her and she dropped her head. And I'm like, But she took the ball on the floor, the elbow, and she penetrated and threw a pass to Kiesha. She hit a jump shot on the baseline. And the other one was, she decided she was going to take the basketball out of bounds for me. And I just looked at her, I'm like, when have you ever in life taken the basketball out of bounds? My bad, coach. I said, you're doing too much. I just need you to do your job. So I was on it earlier today. We were watching film. But what a phenomenal young lady. I mean, all heart, big old teddy bear kid. Everybody loves her. I mean, she's just unbelievable. And getting better every day, you know, having to learn the system and how to play and what our expectations. She's growing. By the end of the season, I think you're going to see a really phenomenal player on the floor, utilizing her body and her size to her advantage. And it's really going to be huge for us going down the road. We're going to really need her to grow her game and, you know, begin to do some things for us in that paint.
Well, from my data and research of a Sandy Pugh-led team, she could be a very key element for long-term success for the Lady Panthers under your leadership with this season that we have ahead. Speaking of this season, you have a critical round one, as we've been dubbing it, coming up against Texas Southern. They're getting a shot, losing against Southern on Monday. What do you see as some of the keys that you guys are going to have to do to roll this thing over to 3-0 heading in toward Jackson and Grambling?
Well, we have to continue to execute on the half-court offense. You know, moving that basketball around, getting to the we shot, not the me, and, you know, finding an open guy. Shayla has to continue to go downhill whenever possible with the basketball. Artie's got to step her game up. Wasn't feeling well at Alcorn, so I she only played limited minutes. But you know, to be able to go out and beat a team, you know, in the conference, you know, on their home court by 20 or more points without one of your, you know, your better players playing the bulk of a minute is a, you know, that's a blessing. And you know, kids like Jaira, Mariah, and Tootie and Keisha really stepped up on their end and did some things. And we're going to need them on Saturday. Texas Southern is, you know, has some kids returning. They have a ton of fifth-year A kids, a couple of guards that can really score the basketball. And Southern did a good job of pressuring them, you know, and I think that's going to be a key for us is, you know, maintaining the pressure. But we got to rebound. They do a good job of going to the boards. You know, we gotta box out and rebound. Defending them is one thing, but you've got to get the rebound. And we've been out rebounded the majority of our games this year, so that has been a cause for concern for me, and you know, something that we've been working on diligently, trying to get them to understand. You know, you got to box, you got to rebound.
I was just going to ask that because with the game, if you allow me to say, being played beneath the rim, your execution is more predicated on doing the little things such as the box out and such as knowing your assignment and lane assignments when it comes to rebounding.
Yeah, exactly. You know, being responsible, you know, going to the, you know, a lot of coaches say, hey, go to the board, you know. And, you know, I don't like to say that. I say box out and rebound, then rebound, you know, instead of just guys go to the boards because, you know, guys go there and just elevate over the rim and go get it. You know, girls, we have to wait for it to come down to us. So, you know, you got to hold that position. But, you know, we got to get better at it. And as we get better at that, I think you'll begin to see more consistency from us. You know, if we got, I'll tell you what, we got to be ready to go Saturday because if we're not boxing on, somebody's going to go get it. And I know Texas Southern, Coach Perry, going to have her kids ready to go box out and beat them to the boards.
We're talking right now with Coach Sandy Pugh of the Lady Panthers. The Panthers 2-0, getting ready to take on the Texas Southern Tigers this coming weekend. How amped up is Ford to be going up against the Tigers this weekend?
You know what? I didn't talk to her much about it. I know that, you know, in tape, she was talking to her teammates. But, you know, we try to keep things in balance. You know, you don't want her to get, you know, too far out of line or out of balance. You want her to focus on what the team needs and not necessarily what, you know, she's going to be doing, you know. So I think she understands that. And, you know, as long as she can come in and be a factor on four, you know, I think she can help her team win. And that's the bottom line. I mean, and the other question is, I really don't know how many of those kids are on that team that she even played with because they have such a new group of kids. They have a lot of new people on their team.
Well, she'll get a chance to introduce herself and reintroduce herself come this weekend as they'll take on the Lady Tigers. Now, Coach, I gotta ask you this question, and it might embarrass you, but it's not meant to embarrass you. But when you're coaching and you see your team as you have it right now, which one of your players most remind you of you and your playing style?
Oh my gosh. Ooh. That's a good question. We really don't have it because, you know, I was such I could score the ball multiple ways. We don't have anyone who can really score the ball that way. And that's a good question.
That's a good question.
We don't really have that a player such as that.
Well, who would be the closest player to your style of play?
I would probably say Tootie because, you know, she's long, she's athletic, she can play multiple positions. She does a good job of, being able to get out on the perimeter and finish in traffic. So just her length probably would be more along the style of player.
Now, you know, but we have some listeners who don't know who Tootie is. Let us know who Tootie is.
Oh, my bad. Lanique Neely.
Yes. I'm just saying, we know, but who is Tootie? Is she is she from the Facts of Life? But no, it's... Now, I need you to fill in this question. The Lady Panthers will win if?
If we play hard-nosed defense and execute in the half-court set. And rebound will be fine.
All right. Coach Sandy Pugh and the Lady Panthers looking to roll 3-0 in this early important matchup of SWAC conference play. Starts at 3 p.m. Central Standard Time at the Baby Dome. It's all white. I don't know if I have a white coat, but I got a white shirt. And I'm not wearing no white jeans, Coach, but I'll be there with my white on.
Well, you have to get there early then. You have to get there early and connect with Coach Pete and get you a T-shirt because they're supposed to be giving T-shirts to, I think, the first five, but don't quote me on it, the first 500 people.
The first 500?
I think so, are getting a free white T-shirt. So, but, hey, everybody come on out. It's going to be a phenomenal atmosphere. You know, the kids are starting to trickle back in. So we're just excited about hosting Texas Southern, more importantly, being back in the Dome. So come on out and support and look forward to seeing them in the building.
All right. Dome, sweet Dome. It all happens at the Billy Nick's Baby Dome, 3 p.m. Saturday. Lady Panthers and the Lady Tigers of Texas Southern, round one. I am the radio guy to Dr. Mike Prince. We're going to pause for the calls and we'll be right back.
Reach more potential customers through our sports radio package by dialing 832-213-8824.
All right, that is going to bring us to a wrap on today's episode of the Mike Prince Show. Want to thank our special guests, Coach Byron Smith and Coach Sandy Pugh. Remember, come on out, celebrate the Panthers taking on the Tigers this Saturday beginning at 3 p.m. in the Baby Dome. Our social media handles, are all the same for Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at The Mike Prince Show. The YouTube channel is Open Mic Broadcast Network. And, of course, our website is obnradio.com. Don't forget our 24-hour message line, 713-570-6736. I want to thank Attorney Lee Van Richardson for being our underwriter for today's episode. He's located at 1047 Austin Street in Hempstead, Texas. That phone number is 979-826-8008. I've got to go, ladies and gentlemen. God bless. Until the next time, we'll see you on the other side.